This is the video which shows the coin which is kept at the bottom of the glass filled with water appears slightly above from its actual position. This is due to refraction. So now I am going to teach you how to calculate a relation between real and apparent depth. अभी मैंने आपको एक वीडियो दिखाया था जहाँ पर ग्लास के अंदर एक कॉइन रखा है और कॉइन की एक्चुअल डेप्थ प्लेस से थोड़ा सा ऊपर उठा हुआ दिख रहा है. दैट इज कॉल्ड एपरेंट डेप्थ, जहाँ दिख रहा है. एंड द रियल डेप्थ इज द बॉटम ऑफ द ग्लास. सो लेट्स कंसीडर दिस इज द टी इज द थिकनेस ऑफ द वॉटर इन द ग्लास. आई कैप्ट कॉइन हेयर. Above this surface of the water is air. From coin, an incident ray I moves from denser to rarer medium, so it moves away from normal. N1, N2. Angle I incidence by definition. Angle R by definition the angle of reflection. This ray is received by the eye and eye forms an image, visualizes an image in a straight line, that is at position I rather than at O. That's why the coin appears little above than the actual position. So here we are going to derive a relation between real and apparent depth. From this figure, angle N OA, or you can also call it as angle C I A, an angle N1 A and E are equal because both are corresponding angles. Angle N, this you can also put it as C O and A is equal to angle O A and 2 is equal to angle I, that are alternate angles. Using Snell's law, sin I over sin R, for small angles when I tends to 0, sin I tends to I, or theta tends to 0, sin theta tends to theta, this you can also put it as tan theta. Therefore, equation 1 becomes W mu A is equal to tan I over tan R. Equation 2. Tan I and tan R value you can calculate from the triangles. From right angle triangle and C O and A, C O and A, you can get tan I is equal to C A over O C. Similarly, from triangle CIA, you can get tan R is equal to CA over CI. This you can put it as equation 4. This is equation 3. Let me make it more clear. Now substitute these values in equation 2. So what you will get? W mu A is equal to tan I is CA over OC. This is CI over CA. CA, CA gets cancelled. You get CI over CO. CI is what? Apparent depth. CO is what? Real depth. This is a relation. But as we know, in case of the refraction, this relation also holds good. Which relation? A mu w into w mu a is equal to 1. It means A mu w is equal to w mu a is what? W mu a is apparent depth over real depth is equal to 1. So A mu w is equal to real depth over apparent depth. This implies apparent depth is equal to real depth by mu. Now if I say T is total depth of the column of water, it's a thickness of the column of water, you can say T. So real depth is how much? T. And if I assume OI is equal to D, this implies apparent depth CI is equal to T minus D. Right? Substituting here, T minus D is equal to T over mu. This says apparent depth or shift, apparent shift, not depth, apparent shift in the image is equal to T minus T over mu. That is 1 minus 1 over mu into T.